Hello students, today we are going to discuss about VB.NET. What is VB.NET? In the session, we are going to discuss about VB.NET, its feature, why it is termed as a professional language, what are its advantages and disadvantages, what are the basic programming structure of VB.NET, how do we compile and execute the VB.NET program. And at last, we will see the example. So, let's see what is VB.NET. VB.NET stands for Visual Basic Network Enabled Technology. It is a simple, high-level, object-oriented programming language which was developed by Microsoft in 2002. It was a successor of Visual Basic 6.0 that is implemented on the Microsoft.NET framework. Furthermore, it supports the object-oriented programming concept such as abstraction, encapsulation, inheritance, and polymorphism. These four features are called the pillar of OOPS concept. Therefore, everything in the VB.NET language is an object, including all primitive data types such as integer, string, char, long, short, boolean, etc. User-defined data types such as class, events, and all objects that inherits from its base class. VB.NET is not a case-sensitive language as compared with C#, C++, and Java. Applications built using the VB.NET language are very reliable and scalable, relying on the .NET framework to access all libraries that help to execute a VB.NET. Applications or programs of VB.NET are not only running on the Windows operating system, but it can also run on Linux or Mac operating system. As we say that VB.NET is not case sensitive, so when we type any code in VB.NET, it gets converted as per the defined classes or data type or any other keywords which are defined in the VB.NET library. And VB.NET is based on the .NET framework, so there is no need to terminate a statement with using any symbols. So whenever you use the new enter, it will create a new line. There are different features of VB.NET. I have listed few of the features here. It is an object-oriented programming language that follows various OOPS concepts such as abstraction, encapsulation, inheritance, data binding, polymorphism, interface, etc. It means that everything in VB.NET programming will be treated as an object. The VB.NET language is used to design user interface for mobile, window, and web-based application. It supports a rapid application development toolkit in which a developer does not need to write all the codes as it can get various codes automatically from its library. For example, when we create form in VB.NET, it automatically calls events of various forms in that class. We just have to write the code for the execution of those. It supports Boolean condition for decision making in programming. It supports the multi-threading concept. It provides simple event management. A window form enabled us to inherit all existing functionality of form that can be used to create a new form. So in this way, it reduces the code complexity. It also supports the feature of SDI and MDI. It uses an external object as a reference that can be used in a VB.NET application. It has its own garbage collector that automatically initializes the garbage collection process. It follows a structured and extensible programming language for error detection and recovery. Conditional compilation, and it provides a generic classes which is easy to use. Now, the term comes why VB.NET is termed as a professional language. There are many reasons, such as it is modern and general purpose programming language. It supports object-oriented features. It has component-oriented. in this, we can say that a form has different controls. So we can say that VB.NET is a component oriented. It is easy to learn. It uses a structured language. It produces efficient program, and it can be compiled on a variety of computer platforms. And the main features which makes VB.NET as a professional language is it is the part of the .NET framework. Now, there are different advantages of VB.NET, such as the VB.NET executes a program in such a way that runs under CLR, creating a robust, stable, and secure application. It is a pure object-oriented programming language based on object and classes. However, these features are not available in the previous version, that is Visual Basic 6.0. That's why Microsoft VB.NET language. Visual Basic 6.0 supports many features such as Windows application development, desktop-based application development, console programming, but it does not support the object-oriented programming. It supports only the structured programming. So there's a need of a language which should support the object-oriented programming. So Microsoft has launched VB.NET language using .NET platform, which it supports which gets supports the object-oriented programming. Using the Visual Studio IDE, one can develop a small programs that works faster with a large desktop and web applications. The .NET framework is a software framework that has a large collection of libraries, which helps in developing more robust applications. VB.NET also provides the features of drop and drag elements to create web forms in .NET applications, as well as desktop-based forms in .NET applications. However, the VB allows to connect one application to another application that created in the same language to run on the .NET framework. Suppose two different modules are developed in the same using the same language and using the same database, then VB.NET allows to connect both applications. A VB.NET can automatically structure the code as it uses the interpreter, so it's structure the code line by line. The Visual Basic .language is also used to transfer data between different layers of the .NET architecture, such that data is passed as simple text string. It has a new concept of event handling, or we can say error handling, in VB.NET framework. The new structure is the try, catch, and finally method, which is used to handle exceptions as a unit. In addition, it allows appropriate action to be taken at the place where it encountered an error. In this way, it discourages the use of the on-error go-to statement in .NET programming. Now, there are some disadvantages of using VB.NET. We can't say it's a disadvantages. We can say it's the limitations of VB.NET. The VB.NET programming language is unable to handle pointers directly, because in this language it requires a lot of programming and it is not easy to manage every address by a pointer. The VB.NET programming is easy to learn. That increases a large competitions between the programmers to apply the same employment or project in VB.NET. Thus, it reduces a secure job in the programming field as a VB.NET developer. As it uses intermediate language compilation that can be easily decompiled, but there's nothing that can prevent an application from this integrating. Just in compiler is used by VB.NET. It is the process through which a computer can interpret intermediate language compilation and is also required to run the application. It means that the target computer needs a JIT compiler to interpret a source program in intermediate language, and this interpretation requires an additional CPU cycle that degrades the performance of an application. So JIT creates a limitations for VB.NET. So here we can see that there are a few limitations, but we know that each and every languages has their own advantages and limitations. So we should prefer to choose the language as per the requirement. Now, let's come to the program structure of a VB.NET. That what is the basic structure on which we should write the program. The very first thing is the namespace declaration, then a class or module, whatever you want to use one or more processor if you include processor in your application. Then variable definition, that is global variable definition. Then main processor, statement and expressions and comments. These are the basic components of the VB.NET program structure. Here, you can see in the diagram listed here, import system. This is the first line which is used to include the system namespace. Here we can use the system namespace using import. The next line is the module declaration. Module is a keyword and module 1 is the module name. Next, the program will display hello world. This is the program to display the hello world message. So I have written this in the comment line. In VB.NET, single quote is used to write the comment. Sub main. Here, sub is a keyword which is used to define the processor. And here, main is the keyword which is used to define the main processor. So sub main is the main processor under which it contains the executable code. console.writeLine.helloWorld. Here, console.writeLine. Console is an object of the class. And writeLine is a method defined under console. And hello world is the parameter which we have passed to create. WriteLine is a function which is used to write a statement on the console. So console.writeLine, hello world. It means the compiler gave permission to the console to write the line hello world. We have to use the double quote symbol to write the text. console.readKey. It is a function. ReadKey is a function which is used to read a key, which is used to take a input from a keyboard. And next, end sub and end module. End is a keyword which is used to close the block. So sub main is the main processor, and end sub is the ending statement of this processor and this end module. A processor could be of any of the following: either function, sub, operator, get, set, add handler, remove handler, raise event. We will discuss each and everything one by one in the upcoming sessions. So here is the basic programming structure of VB.NET, which starts with the import statement and ends with the end module. Now, after writing the code, we have to have an idea that how should we compile and execute the VB.NET program. So there are two different steps. If you use visualstudio.net IDE, then you have to start the Visual Studio. You have to choose file, new project, and from that you can choose your own application. Here, suppose here I have taken the example of console application. So specify your name and location for your project using the browse button and then choose the OK button. The new project appears in Solution Explorer, write code in the code editor and press the F5 key to execute. If you're using Visual Studio IDE, then open a text editor, write the code and save the file as helloworld.vb. Open the command prompt and type vbc helloworld.vb and press enter to compile your code. If there will no error, you have to type hello world to execute your program. And if it contains error, then correct the error and recompile it and then re-execute it. So after the execution, you will able to see that in this way your program will look. Let's see how it works practically. Let me open the file. So here the Visual Studio 2012 is open. Now click on the new project. Either you can check from here new project, or you can go from the menu. So file, click on the file, new project. As we are going for the console application, first choose the template, whatever template you want. I have used Visual Basic. Inside Visual Basic, you have to choose the template, that is either Windows Form application, WPF, console, class library, portable class library, WPF, empty project, Windows services, WPF custom library, WPF use control, Windows Form controls library. So here I'm going to take console application. Now click on OK. As you open the console application, you will get an editor to write the console-based programming using VB.NET. So let it be get open. Here, module 1 is the default module for the project. This is if we are not going to include any namespace in our project, we should omit the use of import keyword. Now I am going to write the code. I am just giving a demonstration how do we print a message. So here I am going to write console dot write line. As you can see, I have typed all in the lowercase, but as it uses interpreter and it is not case sensitive, so it automatically converts in the later as it is defined in the library. Welcome to ISM Patna. I'm just going to write the message. And now if I want to just print this message on the screen, to compile it, there is no need. If you press start button, it will be get auto compile. So now I am going to press the start. So you can able to see it displays, but it terminates as there is no any more instruction. So to hold the system execution, we should write console.readKey so that it will wait for the input of a single character to terminate the program. Now you can able to see the output, welcome to ISM Patna. And now a cursor is blinking, which is waiting for the one character input. I have placed a character, any character you may press. And now you can able to see the termination of the program. So here we have seen a programming demonstration to print a single message on the VB.NET platform using console-based programming. Here I have said that single quote is used as a comment line. The comment line is a line which is not executable. We give current line only for the readability of the code. Suppose I am giving the line program to display a message. So as you can able to see, the color highlighted is green, that it shows that it is a comment line. You can also give comment line using the user interface. Suppose I am giving I am going to eliminate this, and now I want to create a comment line. So select the line and just click on the comment of the selected lines, or you can also use the shortcut key Ctrl+K to make your line as a comment line. So we have discussed how to write a comment line, how to execute the console based application in VB.NET. Hope you have learned about the basic programming structure of the VB.NET. In upcoming sessions, we will discuss about variables, identifiers, keywords, reserved words, operators, and many more about VB.NET. Thank you, class, for watching the session. Thank you very much.